Remember the Nissan Pulsar? Well, it's been 6 years since a Pulsar nameplate has adorned the rear of a small car from Nissan. With one in four cars sold coming from the small car segment, Nissan needed something to compete with the big boys. And the Pulsar name ranks alongside Toyota's Corolla as one of the most recognisable in that segment. A strong suit of the new Pulsar is space, and this new sedan has lots of it. In the rear, there's a 510 litre cargo volume capacity. That's almost as much as the Nissan Maxima. And it's not just in the boot that the Pulsar's big on space. In the rear here, there's a mountain of space for passengers. There's a wide opening door aperture, heaps of leg room, adequate headroom, nicely upholstered leather seats. Pricing for the new Pulsar sedan range starts at just $19,990. That's for a manual 1.8 ST. We're driving the top spec Ti, and it's priced at $28,990. The new Pulsar sedan has an all-new 1.8 litre petrol engine, and it's matched to a constantly variable, or CVT, transmission. The engine has variable valve timing, and from its 1.8 litre capacity, develops 96 kilowatts of power and 174 newton metres worth of torque. The new Pulsar range has a conventional suspension setup, and it's definitely biased towards driver comfort. The steering's way too light for me and doesn't provide much feel, especially out on the highway. But around town, it's nice and light, and that makes parking easy. One of the highlights of the new Pulsar is its fuel economy. Like a lot of small cars these days, the CVT transmission helps in providing great fuel consumption. Out on our highway loop, we recorded the excellent figure of 6.2 litres per 100 k's. Around town, it's not quite that good, 10 litres per 100 k's. The inside of this Ti spec Pulsar is nicely finished and well appointed, with features like a reverse camera and satellite navigation. But it lacks a contemporary look and feel of some of its competitors, and it looks a little bit mainstream. So, does this new Nissan Pulsar cut it after such a long absence in the market? Well, if you're after a sporty drive, you're better off waiting until the Triple S version is launched later this year. This new Pulsar sedan is going to appeal to a buyer that's looking for a roomy, well-appointed and economical sedan that's easy to drive around town.